Okay, let's start the topic with Pelton wheel. So this is the Pelton wheel turbine. Okay, so before we start this, we should know that we have two types of vanes in turbines. Okay, the first one is known as fixed vanes. Okay, so fixed vanes are the vanes through which the water or the fluid are directed to the rotor. Means through the fixed vanes, fluid is directed to the rotor of the turbine. Okay, so these fixed vanes can be on the nozzles or on the stator. A stator means the stationary parts of turbines that are not moving. Okay, so fixed blades are associated with stators or nozzles, which are a stationary part of the turbine. And moving blades are associated with rotor of the turbine, means the rotating parts of the turbine. Okay, so moving blades are on the rotor and fixed blades are on the stator or nozzle. So this fixed blade and moving blade will be associated both with reaction turbine also. Now let's start with Pelton wheel, which is an impulse turbine. Okay, so in impulse turbine, you know that we have only kinetic energy at the inlet of the turbine. So this is the Pelton wheel. Okay, so this is the reservoir. Okay, and from the reservoir we have a penstock. This is the serve stack in between. Okay, and this is the water coming out of the nozzle. Okay, this impacts on the blades on the runner. Okay, and this moves, and finally the water dumps into the tail race. Okay, means tail race is the level. So finally dumps into the sink. Okay, now this is the second picture of the Pelton turbine. Okay, so here you can see that this is the penstock, and here we have a spear to control the discharge. Okay, so to control the discharge we have a spear, and to control the since we control the flow, we have change in pressure, means pressure hammer forms, which is handled with the surge tank. Okay, so this is penstock and this is the spear to control the discharge. Now this is the Pelton wheel. So from the water coming out of the nozzle, we have the turbine rotating. Okay, so this is the spiral case, this is the tailstock. We don't have a draft tube in impulse turbine, so in Pelton wheel we don't have any draft tube. Okay, draft tube is associated only with reaction turbine. Okay, now we have buckets. The vanes are known as buckets. This is the runner and this is the pitch diameter. The dotted part is known as pitch diameter. Okay, this is the diameter we will be concerned with in Pelton wheel. Okay, now this is the kind of buckets or vanes in Pelton wheel. Okay, so this is the buckets and Pelton wheel, and jet impacts on the middle part, means this the center part, the curved one, jet impacts on this portion. Okay, and finally evenly distributes from one portion and another portion, means full mass is striking out on this position and half mass gets its output, gets out from this portion and gets out from this portion. Half the fluid gets out from this portion. Okay, now we have velocity triangle of Pelton turbine. Okay, so this is the bucket. In the middle we are impacting the jet. Okay, so jet is striking at the middle of the bucket. and finally the fluid comes out in both the direction. So we are making the velocity triangle only above, but we will have the same velocity triangle in opposite direction here also. But since the half of the mass is coming from here and half of the mass will be coming from here, so and both the, since a symmetric blade, okay, so due to symmetry half of the portion will come from here and half of the portion will come from here, so we are making only one velocity diagram, okay, because the same velocity diagram will be in this bottom also, okay. So we don't need to draw this, we are only drawing this because this, the same similar triangle will be drawn in here also, similar or concurrent, not just similar, concurrent. This will be drawn here. So we have, this is the velocity triangle of Pelton turbine, okay. So first one we have V1 is equal to VW1, VW is the whirl velocity, VR is relative velocity, okay, and VF is flow velocity, okay, U is blade velocity, okay. So first we have V1 is equal to VW1, means absolute velocity at inlet is equal to whirl velocity at inlet. Then this is the blade velocity at inlet, U1, and this is the relative velocity at inlet, VR1, okay. Then similarly we have VR2, V2, VF2, VW2 and U2. U means blade velocity at outlet, VW2 is whirl velocity at outlet, VF2 is flow velocity at outlet, V2 is absolute velocity at outlet, and VR2 is relative velocity at outlet, okay. Now different angles in the velocity triangle are shown here. Now this delta is the angle of deflection, okay. Delta is the angle of deflection, means that angle between V1 and V2, okay. So delta is the angle between V1 and V2. Now phi, we have first phi. So phi is the blade or vane angle at outlet, and then we have beta is equal to fixed blade angle, fixed blade inlet angle or guide blade inlet angle, okay, or absolute velocity at outlet angle, okay. You have to remember this, that we are saying absolute velocity at outlet angle, but fixed blade of inlet angle and guide blade at inlet angle. Fixed blade is nothing but guide blade, okay, or it is can be said as the blade of the blades installed on the stator, okay, and nozzle. So nozzle angle also, so nozzle, stator, fixed blade, guide blade, all are stationary terms, okay, means the stationary part of the turbine. So this is inlet for those stationary terms and outlet for the absolute velocity. So beta is equal to fixed blade inlet angle or guide blade inlet angle and absolute velocity at outlet angle, outlet, okay. So absolute velocity at outlet angle, okay. Now we have U is equal to blade velocity, VF is equal to flow velocity, VW is equal to whirl velocity, VR is equal to relative velocity, and V is the absolute velocity, okay. So in this figure you can see that the V consists of VW and VF, okay, means VW and VF are the components of V2, okay. Similarly VR2 and U2 are the components of V2, means VR means relative velocity and blade velocity, okay, both combine to give the absolute velocity, and flow and whirl are the components that join to give the V velocity, okay. So VW and VF are the components of V, similarly U and VR are the components of V, okay. So it happens everywhere, whether it's inlet or outlet, the same thing happens. V2 is the summation of, means the vector summation of VW and VF, and also V is a vector summation of U2 and VR, okay. Means U and VR, okay. So you can express V in terms of VW and VF, or you can express V in terms of U and VR. Okay, now this is the velocity triangle. So U is known as blade velocity, if BF is flow velocity, VW is whirl velocity, VR is relative velocity, and V is the absolute velocity. Okay. Now we have runner power or work power, runner power or work done per second. Okay. So this is equal to rho V dot VW1 plus VW2 into U. Okay. So U is common for U1 is equal to U2. Pi dn by 60. So we are only writing U here because there is no difference between U1 and U2, and we are writing only magnitude portion, so you don't have to consider, you don't have to do anything about in this formula. This is, this will give the magnitude of the runner power. Okay, all the direction parts have been considered, you don't have to worry about that. So this is the magnitude of runner power or work done per second. Okay, means rho V dot VW1 plus VW2 into U. Okay, now hydraulic or blade efficiency is equal to runner power by kinetic energy at inlet. So this is V1 minus U 1 plus cos phi into U by V1 square by 2. Okay, because this is nothing but runner power is equal to rho V dot VW1 plus VW2 into U is equal to rho V dot into V1 minus U plus 1 plus cos phi into U. Okay, this whole term will be equal to rho V dot into V1 minus U 1 plus cos phi into U. Okay, so hydraulic efficiency or blade efficiency is equal to runner power by kinetic energy at inlet. So both these terms, V1 minus U 1 plus cos phi into U by V1 square by 2, are per unit mass terms. Okay, we from the numerator and denominator, we cancel the rho V dot term, rho into V dot means density into volumetric flow rate. So we cancelled from the numerator and denominator. So we have remained with only per unit mass terms. Okay, so this is runner power per unit mass, and this is kinetic energy at inlet per unit mass. Okay, and also volumetric flow rate is area of cross section into flow velocity. So A into V1. Okay, V dot is equal to A into V1. A is the area of cross section of the nozzle, and V1 is the velocity of the flow coming out of the nozzle. Now sigma mass or maximum hydraulic efficiency of the Pelton turbine is equal to 1 plus cos phi by 2, which occurs when U is equal to V1 by 2. Okay, so maximum efficiency is equal to 1 plus cos phi by 2, which occurs at U is equal to V1 by 2. Now V1 is the velocity of the jet at inlet. Okay, or the velocity of jet is equal to CV into root 2 GH. CV is the coefficient of velocity. Coefficient of velocity into root 2 GH. If you are not given coefficient of velocity, then only root 2 GH. Now we have a speed ratio is equal to U by V1. U is equal to pi dn by 60, blade velocity, and V1 is the velocity of jet. Okay, velocity of plate, pi dn by 60. Now we have jet ratio. So jet ratio is diameter of the wheel by diameter of the jet. Okay, this is jet ratio is denoted by small m. So jet ratio is equal to capital D by small d, where capital D is equal to diameter of the wheel and or pitch diameter of the wheel. Okay, and d is the diameter of the jet. Okay, now number of buckets is equal to m by 2 by 50 by 15. Okay, so m is the jet ratio. So jet ratio by 2 plus 15 is equal to number of buckets. Then we have u1 is equal to u2 is equal to pi dn by 60. Okay, and vr1 is equal to vr2 for a smooth pipe, for a smooth vanes line, it's written, it should be vane. Okay, for a smooth blades, we have VR1 is equal to VR2. For a smooth blades, it's written line, change it to blades. Okay, So we have VR1 is equal to VR2 for a smooth blades or vanes. Now V dot is equal to A into V1. Okay. A is the area of the nozzle. V1 is the velocity of the nozzle. Velocity of the jet coming out of the nozzle. Now torque experience, power loss in runner. So power loss in runner is equal to half MV1 square minus runner power. So half MV1 square is the energy available at the inlet of the turbine. Okay. Means energy available, initial energy that is given to the turbine. So half MV1 square is there. And minus runner power means the power that reaches the runner. Okay. So power loss in runner is equal to half MV1 square minus RP. Okay. Means the power given by the runner. Okay. Now power loss in the nozzle is equal to rho V dot GH minus MV1 square. Means this one was the measure. If there were no any power loss in the nozzle, okay, then this rho V dot GH is equal to half MV1 square. Means whatever the potential energy term we have is equal to kinetic energy term, okay. But if you have power loss in the nozzle, means the nozzle is also bearing some power loss issue. So they, in that case, rho into V dot GH minus MV1 square by 2 means this is the kinetic energy that will be given to the Pelton wheel, and this is the potential energy that was having with the reservoir. H is the net head. Okay. So this was the energy that was given by the reservoir, and MV1 square is the energy given to the Pelton wheel. Okay. So rho is the density of water, V dot is the volumetric flow rate, G is the gravity, H is the net head, and MV1 square by 2 means the kinetic energy given to the Pelton wheel. Okay. Now number of jets is equal to total discharge by discharge from one jet, or total volumetric flow rate by volumetric flow rate of one jet. Now torque on the wheels or turbine is equal to rho V dot VW1 plus VW2 into R. R is pitch radius. Okay. It's written U, it will be changed to R. Don't worry. So it's R. Okay. So R is the pitch radius. Okay. So torque on the wheel or turbine is equal to rho V dot VW1 plus VW2 into R. Okay. Or rho V dot into V1 minus U 1 plus cos phi into R, because this VW1 plus VW2 is nothing but V1 minus U into 1 plus cos phi. Okay, this VW1 plus VW2 is nothing but V1 minus U plus V1 minus U into 1 plus cos phi. Okay, and R is the pitch radius, rho is the density, V dot is volumetric flow rate. So runner power is equal to rho V dot VW1 plus VW2 into U, or runner power per kg is equal to VW1 plus VW2 into U. Okay, so we exclude this rho V dot term. So rho V dot term we exclude, we get power per kg. Okay, this is joule and this is joule per kg. So this is V1 minus U 1 plus cos phi into U. Okay, so thank you.